Viewers, welcome to Yamini's Kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how to make aloo gobi or cauliflower potato stir fry. Before going to the video, like, share and subscribe my channel. I know that there are many versions of aloo gobi or cauliflower potato stir fry in our household. Now it's gaining fame throughout the world. I have tried many versions of aloo gobi using dry mango, tomato puree and curd. Of course, you can add whichever appeals to you. But for this recipe, I'm using simple ingredients available at home for preparing this recipe. This is my favorite version. Bring a large pot of water to boil. Cut the cauliflower, wash it and drop carefully in the boiling water. Leave for 3 to 5 minutes. Switch off the flame. Drain the cauliflower thoroughly with a strainer. Heat a pan and add 1 tablespoon of oil. Now transfer the cauliflower and saute it till it turns light brown and transfer it to your bowl. Heat oil in a pan. Over medium heat add a bay leaf, 1 cinnamon stick, 2 cloves and 1/2 tablespoon jeera. Let them sizzle for few seconds. Make sure the jeera doesn't burn. Add the chopped garlic pods and grated ginger. Saute for about 30 to 35 seconds until a raw smell disappears. Now add the sliced onions and stir frequently until they turn pink. Add the tomatoes along with the potatoes and mix well. I'm going to add all the masalas. First, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of salt. You can change it according to the taste. Then, I'm going to add 1/2 tablespoon turmeric powder and 1 tablespoon chili powder and coriander powder. And at last, 1/2 tablespoon garam masala powder. Mix it well. Add 150 ml of water to the pan and cover it with a lid. Put the gas in medium flame. Cook till potatoes are 3/4 done. At this stage, add cauliflower and sprinkle water. Cook till oil separates. Stir once or twice in between so that the vegetable doesn't stick to the pan. This may take around 20 to 25 minutes. When the veggies are cooked, turn off the heat and garnish with coriander leaves. Mouth-watering aloo gobi is ready to serve with chapati, sambar rice or curd rice. It takes only 25 to 30 minutes to prepare this recipe. Try it at home and let me know how it was. See you in the next video. Bye!